What's up guys? Today's video is on the top 5 best motherboards for Ryzen 9 3900X. So I made the list from personal opinion, in hours of research, and I've included different options for every type of buyer. As always, all links to the product mentioned in the video will be in the description box, down below. Like the video, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. So, here are the top 5 best motherboards for Ryzen 9 3900X. The fifth product on our list is MSI B450 Tomahawk Max. This is our pick for the best budget motherboards for Ryzen 9 3900X. It is available for around $200. It measures 12-inch width, 9.6-inch in depth while weighing a total of 2.6 pounds. Built on the AMD B450 chipset, the B450 Tomahawk Max motherboard supports third-generation AMD Ryzen processors with the AM4 socket. Its four memory slots support a max of 64GB of DDR4 RAM that can be overclocked up to 4133MHz. For storage, there are 6 SATA 3 ports as well as a Turbo M.2 slot, utilizing the PCIe 3.0x4 interface. While the motherboard is equipped with DVI-D and HDMI outputs for integrated graphics, it also has a PCIe 3.0x16 slot for a dedicated graphics card. Other notable integrated features include Realtek ALC-892 7.1 channel HD audio and Realtek 8111H gigabit LAN. This motherboard features an extended PWM heatsink and an enhanced circuit design. Equipped with DDR4 Boost, Audio Boost, Core Boost, and Easy Debug LED, the B450 Tomahawk Max provides the performance you need to build your own gaming rig. The right side of the motherboard also supports MSI Mystic Light RGB lighting. The AMD B450 chipset delivers high performance and flexibility with the AMD AM4 socket Ryzen processors. It offers AMD Stormy storage acceleration technology. The right side of this motherboard features built-in LED lighting. Choose from over a million colors and a variety of lighting effects to fit your style. You can also sync it with other MSI Mystic Light compatible hardware and peripherals to complete your build. Some of the pros for this product include the affordable price point, decent VRM. It has 6 fan headers. And it comes equipped with USB 3.1, USB Type-C, and M.2 32 gigabits per second. However, a con for this product is that the RGB headers are not independently controllable. An M.2 slots with PCIe connectivity is available thanks to it being an AM4-based motherboard. M.2 SSDs with the advanced NVMe Express protocol and that are connected via 4 PCI Express 3.0 lanes are up to 8 times as fast as SATA 6G hard drives and support data transfer rates of up to 32 gigabits per second. The fourth product on our list is Asus TUF Gaming X570 Plus AM4 ATX motherboard. This is our second pick for the best budget motherboards for Ryzen 9 3900X. At this time, you can get it at around a maximum of $200. It weighs 2.6 pounds, and measures 13x11x3 inches. It comes with PCIe 4.0 support, dual PCIe 4.0 M.2 slots, Wi-Fi, and a USB 3.1 Gen 2 Type-C port outback, among other features. The Asus TUF Gaming motherboard is built on the AMD X570 chipset supporting 2nd and 3rd generation AMD Ryzen processors with an AM4 socket. It has 4 memory slots for up to 128GB of dual-channel DDR4 RAM, which can run up to 4400MHz when overclocked. For storage, it's equipped with 8 SATA 3 ports and 2 22110 M.2 slots. There are 2 PCIe 4.0x16 slots for graphics cards, which can run at 16x4 when both slots are filled, and another 3 PCIe 4.0x1 slot for other PCI-based hardware. Other integrated features include Realtek L8200A Gigabit LAN and Realtek ALC-S1200A 8-channel HD audio. The AMD X570 chipset is designed around 3rd-generation AMD Ryzen 3000 series processors. Along with multiple improvements, its most noteworthy one is the addition of PCIe 4.0. The PCIe 4.0 has roughly double the bandwidth of PCIe 3.0, which is beneficial for graphics cards, networking devices, NVMe drives, and more. The PCB is jet black with a line pattern making its way from the bottom right corner through the left VRM area and rear I.O. The rear I.O. shield has TUF Gaming branding on top with some yellow accents scattered throughout the board. Some of the pros of this product include a low price, debug LEDs, USB 3.1 Gen 2 Type-C port, and Wi-Fi included. A con for this product is the lack of front panel USB 3.1 Gen 2 port. The DIMM slots alternate black and gray, in keeping with the overall visual theme of the board, giving some accent to the all-black PCIe slots. Additionally, the top slot is protected with ASUS Safe Slot metal wrapping. Other connectors and slots are black, except for the RGB headers. The third product on our list is MSI MEGX 570 Ace motherboard. Our pick for the best high-end motherboard for Ryzen 9 3900X. It is available at around $370. It measures 12-inch width, 9.6-inch in depth while weighing a total of 2.2 pounds. Equipped with a 14-phase VRM solution, a well-designed onboard cooling system, and triple M.2 slots, the MSI MEGX 570 Ace is aiming to prove its worth in the enthusiast segment of the AM4 market. Aside from the power delivery solution and visual pointers, the MSI MEGX 570 Ace is well equipped with useful features. You get 3 M.2 slots, all of which can be used simultaneously whilst also featuring a smart cooling system. And for networking gurus, 2.5 gigabits Ethernet, and 2.4 gigabits per second 802.11ax Wi-Fi, accompany the usual gigabit port. One clear area of differentiation for MSI is its heatsink design. The inclusion of a heat pipe connecting the MOSFETs to the chipset heatsink is touted as improving motherboard operation by making a portion of the fan's active cooling capacity available to the VRM. MSI put 7 fan headers on the motherboard, all of them are hybrid PWM DC mode fans. By default, the 2 headers circled in red are in PWM mode while the 5 circled in blue are DC mode fans. However, you can change the mode of each header individually. The UEFI BIOS is pretty much identical to the previous ones from MSI for both Intel and AMD platforms. You have both an advanced mode and an easy mode, where you will do most of your overclocking. Otherwise, the UEFI is loaded with all the latest features and settings to tune your new 3rd generation Ryzen CPU, including the FCLK. The fan control is quite good, and it's in the form of a GUI, and you have control over the chipset fan. Some of the pros for this product include, all 3 long PCIe and M.2 slots are enabled simultaneously. Superior DRAM overclocking data rate. PCH heat pipe may allow greater fan idle time. And 2.5 gigabits Ethernet, plus gigabit Ethernet, plus Wi-Fi 6. A con for this product, only one PCIe X1 slot can be used at a time. A notable design feature is MSI's RGB Infinity Mirror 2, which is integrated into the rear panel cover. The rear panel I/O comes attached with a black and red pre-installed I/O shield. There is also an LED debug, a front panel USB 3.1 G2 Type-C, an overclocker's toolkit with power reset buttons, and an MSI boost dial which gives users the option to use the onboard CPU overclocking profiles without entering the BIOS. The second product on our list is ASRock X570 Tai-Chi. This is our pick for the best micro ATX motherboard for Ryzen 9 3900X. It is available for around $200. As for the ASRock X570 Tai-Chi, it holds to the Tai-Chi theme, but with a significant update to the implementation. The new look is modernized and features an even more premium build quality and feature set, from the newly integrated rear I/O shield to the metal backplate or intricate cog and gear motif. The ASRock X570 Tai-Chi even features Wi-Fi 6 support, offering the best wireless connectivity available. For power delivery, it relies on a 14-phase VRM design, which should handle even the yet-to-release AMD Ryzen 3950X. The box is of a new design, it's larger and quite nice. The packaging is excellent and should do a great job of protecting the motherboard. The accessory package includes 4 SATA 6 gigabits per second, Wi-Fi antenna, hex screwdriver, SLIHB bridge, case badge, and M.2 screws. ASRock put 6 fan headers on the motherboard, and the one circled in blue is the 1A PWM header for the CPU fan. The other 5 headers circled in red are rated for up to 2A and are hybrid PWM DC mode header. The rear I/O panel features 6 USB 3.0 ports, 2 USB 3.1 ports, 1 Type-A port and 1 Type-C. Clear CMOS button, flashback button, Wi-Fi antenna, 1 GLAN, HDMI, PS2 keyboard and mouse, and 7.1 gold-plated audio outputs with SPDIF out. At the bottom of the motherboard, we find a power button, reset button, postcode display, and 2 USB 2.0 internal headers. We also find an addressable RGB LED header and a normal RGB LED header. At the center of the motherboard near the CPU socket, we find an RGB LED header and a single USB header for AMD's Prism cooler. The motherboard features one 8-pin CPU power header and another optional 4-pin header. Some of the pros for this product include 3 PCIe 4.0 M.2 slots, 600 of VRM, Wi-Fi 6, fan, USB and RGB headers near CPU socket is smart. RGB control within the UEFI. A con for this product is that the noisy fan must be manually turned down. The VRM is in a 12+2 phase configuration, and it uses doublers to get the phase count up to 12 phases. The PWM controller is the new controller from Intersil, and it's a 7-phase PWM controller in a 6+1 phase mode that outputs to 7 ISL 6617 doublers. And coming in the first place, we have the MSIB450i Gaming Plus AC. This is our pick for the best mini ITX motherboard for Ryzen 9 3900X. You can get it for around $150. This board is of course a mini ITX motherboard, so it has a pretty small footprint, but perfect for those small form factor builds. MSI does keep the gaming theme on this board with a black PCB with black and red accents. The two heatsinks are black and have a red zigzag design on them. Taking up a good part of the board is AMD's AM4 CPU socket. This socket supports first and second generation Ryzen processors, but since this is a B450 chipset, you will get the second generation features like XFR2 and Precision Boost Overdrive. The board has a 6+2 power phase design, 6 CPU, 2 memory, and power delivery components are cooled by a pretty large heatsink. Above the CPU socket are your 4-pin CPU fan and optional CPU fan headers. Besides those, you have your easy debug LEDs, which will help you troubleshoot any issues if your system is not booting. Hiding at the top of the board is your 8-pin EPS connector. Moving over from the CPU socket, you have your two DDR4 DIMM slots, which support up to 32GB of DDR4 3466+OC memory. Along the edge of the board, you'll find a single USB 2.0 header, USB 3.0 header, 24-pin ATX power connection, 4 SATA ports, and 2 4-pin RGB headers. The RGB headers can be controlled by MSI's Mystic Light software. Along the bottom of the board, you of course have your single PCI Express 3.0x16 slot, which is metal reinforced. This is good as this is such a small board, and if you install a larger graphics card, you are going to want the stability. Right above the PCI Express slot is the heatsink for the chipset. At the bottom corner of the board is the audio solution. MSI has gone with the Realtek AL887, which offers 7.1 channel high definition audio. There are a couple of high-end audio capacitors visible here, as well as the PCB isolation traces. Some of the pros for this product include overclocking capabilities, impressive VRM configuration and VRM cooling, built-in Wi-Fi, AC and Bluetooth, full-blown B450 chipset features. However, a con for this product is that it has only one NVMe. Overclocking on Ryzen systems is very easy to do, sometimes even easier than doing on Intel systems. With this board, there are a few different ways you could do your overclock. The easiest would be the Game Boost function, which will run a few cores at the 4.15 GHz. MSI is using their Click BIOS 5 on this motherboard. You should be pretty familiar with it if you've purchased an MSI motherboard in the past few years. Thank you for watching it. And that's all for now. Hope to see you now in the next video. Till next time, see you guys later.